Hello, my name is Monica Little, and I'm an application engineer at Keysight Technologies. And I'm here today to present our new IntegraVision Power Analyzer. For that reason, we built together a demo kit board, which has on it several devices, as you can see. What we evaluate here today, it is a DC-AC inverter. For that reason, we need to feed it the DC 12 volt signal, and on output, we load it with this battery charger. So our device under test is DC-AC inverter, and we will connect on each side with our power channels. So I will make the connections now. So yellow is my first power channel. So this is my direct current measurement. And this is my voltage measurement for the first power channel. So it's that one is on the input of the DC-AC inverter, so that will be the DC signal. Now this is my second power channel. Again, direct current measurement and voltage measurement on the second power channel. So first I have to check if I have properly set my inputs. Internal input is on 2 amp because we have 2 amps and 50 amps direct input. When I have it set properly, now I can go to auto scale just to make it quick and easy. Auto scale will obviously figure out by itself what in which scales I measure. It also helps to switch on the board. Now I can go to auto scale again. So the yellow, as we started with that theme, yellow is the first channel, green is the second channel. So on first channel I have the DC signals, obviously this is my DC voltage, this is my DC current and my DC power. On green, that's my AC side. As we can see, this small inverter is producing pretty chopped AC voltage. And as I am loading it with battery charger, this battery charger is drawing this very peak, sharp narrow peaks current. That's the green, and this is the power. So now I evaluated that my signals are pretty much where I expected them. Next step probably would be to go analyze my signals. So first I have to set up when I want to go to power quality, the whole cycle analysis mode. It has to be synchronized to either AC signal or the line so it can find edges. Once I have it synchronized, now I have power quality of first channel. And simultaneously, I can also observe power quality of second channel. So power quality, we means it's all different voltages, AC, DC voltages, currents, power, reactive power, power factor, phase angle, and also I can measure nicely the high crest factor. From there, I can go and since I see that I have power going through both input and output, I can see what efficiency this inverter is operating with. At this point, it's 40%. It's not very high. It's probably also because we are only loading this with battery charger, which is drawing not very high current. From there, if I am interested, I can find out what how much energy I'm consuming and the and power charge. That's has to be started extra the measurement. It's default setting to 10 seconds, but it can be changed if I want to observe it for a longer time, for an hour, whatever is the right cycle for me to observe. And last not least, I can go observe and evaluate harmonics. As we seen that the signal what we are drawing, the current on the AC side is very choppy. So let's look at the current, second current analysis. And I can change my views. I can have everything in one screen if I want to. I have the graph and the numerical values of harmonics. And I also see total harmonic distortion. It's pretty high, as we commented. We have a lot of harmonics, as we can see. And if I am just want to see what is my 13 or 14 or whatever, I just touch it and it will let me know what is the harmonics here. Thank you.